God bless you, God bless you, God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. My name is Apostle Peter Daniel. You are watching me right now in Heaven and Hell live program and under the umbrella of School of Heaven. School of Heaven. By the special grace of God, we shall be talking about the 250 errors, over 250 errors that the Christians are committing that is taking them to hell. By the special grace of God, this errors was handed over to me by the Lord Jesus Christ, and he gave me this so that I can tell everyone to be careful about it and so that they can make it to heaven. By the special grace of God, we start yesterday, which is January 22, 2024. Those School of Heaven have been existing, and the lectures have been going around in several places, but we just started the online one yesterday. By the grace of God, we want to go straight to the Word of God. The second error that is going on in the body of Christ. Yesterday we talked about matchmaking of trying to matchmaking the brother of or a sister to marry themselves. Try to matchmaking a brother or a sister to marry themselves when God has not approved it. Trying to matchmaking them when God has not approved it. There are details and serious things in this matter, and there are a lot of problem that is happening in homes now because of matchmaking. So matchmaking is not the will of God. Today we are going to be talking about joining a pregnant woman together with a man in the church. Joining a pregnant woman together in the church. Is it right to join a pregnant woman together? Let's quickly pray as we start. Everlasting Father, we want to bless your name because you are faithful. Thank you for not failing us. Thank you for being with us. Spirit of the Father, Jesus Christ, we want to see you. Speak to us. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Is it proper to join a pregnant woman together in the church? It's a deadly and satanic thing when a pastor joins a couple together on the altar of God when the wife is pregnant. Joining two people together, joining somebody together to be a couple and have an adequate legal marriage, that person has to be single and a single. The man must not be pregnant, neither the woman must also not be pregnant. The man must not be pregnant, the woman must not be pregnant, because there are some states now, or there are some countries now, that the woman there and the man there are pregnant, and they will still join together and they declare that they are joining couples together. So that is why it has to be, the man must not be joined together with the woman. If the pregnancy, the man is pregnant, there are some people that they have removed their wombs. They remove their wombs and they remove what their wombs and turn themselves to a man. And there are some men that also do the same thing. They remove their private part and turn themselves to a woman. Any Christian should not try to marry such person. Any Christian should not try to marry such a person. Even though that person in the future later repented and decided to turn back to a man. Probably let me say that a man who turned himself to a woman. And in the future, the man repented and later decided that he wanted to go back to his man. Inasmuch he has cut away the penis, inasmuch he has cut away the private part, no human being should marry such a person, because the person has been defiled. Though God can forgive, but the person does not have the ability or the license to get married again. Inasmuch the person has destroyed the purpose of God for his life, he has destroyed it. Then let him suffer it. Though God can show you mercy and he make it to heaven, but he cannot go marry again. So what am I trying to say? One of the problem the church are having now is joining a couple together. What is the implications of a pastor joining a woman and a man together and the woman is pregnant? What is the consequence? What is the punishment? Number one, the pastors has committed a grievous offense against the kingdom of God, and that pastors will be severely punished by God. I want you to know that the altar of God and the church of God is actually the sanctuary and the habitation of God, where the presence of God lives. It's like coming to an altar of God, coming to a court of God, and try to do something that is not proper. And God is a justice God. When it comes to an altar should be a holy vessel, a holy sanctuary, a holy altar unto him. If anything is being done there that is against the word of God, that is against his agenda, God will look for the person who do it and make sure that they punish the person. The two sons of Aaron that was killed by the fire was because they do something that is not supposed to be done, which they call strange fire burning. They went there to go and offer the strange fire in the temple of God, and the result is that God have to strike them with consuming fire and burn them down. So when a pastor do this kind of things, number one is that they will force remove your name from the book of life. Your name will be removed away from the book of life. That's number one. Number two, your office and your priesthood will be suspended in heaven for a main time, which means that if you did not come to God for repentance, for a sincere repentance and sincere restitutions, the Lord himself is going to remove you from being a vessel. There are some offenses that you should not try to make at all. When you try to make it, you sin against the four corner of heaven. What I mean by four corner of heaven is that the pillar of heaven. The kingdom of God is not a place where you just go there and begin to do anything anyhow. God does not joke with his house. Well, anything that is being done on the altar is seriously scared. What I mean by sacred, what I mean is that it's very holy. So God expects that everything a man does in his house is in a holy format, is in a perfect format, without any sin at all. If anybody in any means does anything that can make his house defile, what he does is this. He makes sure that the person gets punished immediately. He makes sure that the person gets punished immediately. And one of the punishments is that he suspends you from being a priest. Oh, that is the reason why the Holy Spirit is no more in the church of some people. God have retaken away the temple or the church name of some people in heaven, because every church has their own record in heaven. Every church has their own book in heaven. So when you do something that is defiling, you will never know why the Holy Spirit will be grievously leave your church. One of the things that can make him to grievously leave your church is that you decided to join a couple, a man and a woman, and the woman is pregnant. That is the reason why, as a church, you needed to make sure that the woman exercised and went through pregnant test before you conduct any dedications in the church. Otherwise, it will be a dangerous mess. Why? Before a marriage can be conducted, original legalistic marriage can be conducted and be approved by God, the man must not be pregnant, he must be real man, and the woman must be real woman. He must not have pregnant, because the moment the woman have pregnant, you are joining three persons together. You are joining the man, the woman, and the child together, and that is taboo. A warning is an abomination. There are some things that should not be done at all, that God will not want to hear explanations. There are some things that God will not want to hear explanation. And one of the things is that you do your wedding with pregnancy. God will not approve it. If you want to do your engagement, make sure that, and you want God to approve it, make sure that you are not pregnant. Otherwise, it will not be approved by God. These are the reasons why you have to be very careful when you deal with God. God, you have to be very careful. So may the Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is one of the things that is causing problem in some people's marriage. Some people will get married, and after they have married for a while or for a long time, they'll begin to have problems, serious problems. And not knowing that their problem is on the problem starts from the day they went to the altar, to the temple of the Lord, to go and conduct, to go and wed with pregnancy. When you go to the altar to go and wed with pregnancy, what happened to you is that instead of being blessed, curse will be raised. If it is engagement, that one is still minor. If you went to an engagement with a pregnancy, that one is still little. That is a sin to God and to man, but that one is too little compared to the house of God. When you talk about house of God, and you went to the house of God to go and have a marriage in the temple of God with pregnancy, God will never approve it, and will not release His blessing. What happened is that God will release curse on that marriage, and the marriage will begin to have problem, one problem or the other. So these are the one of the things you have to know. May the Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Another thing I quickly want to say is this. Let me quickly tell you this. There are some Christians that they are being addressed. They are being addressed as couples when they are not couples. For example, because somebody is going to your church, you begin to address such a person by calling the person Mr. or Mrs. And you as a man of God, or as a servant of God, or as a brethren, you did not find out. You begin to address them as husband and wife. You begin to address them as a couple. Meanwhile, this man has not been the dowry of the woman. The Lord and the heaven will hold you in. We hold you responsible for that statement. The statement husband and wife is not something you can just bear. It takes you to have to earn it. And how you are going to earn it is by doing the proper thing, paying the dowry, and making sure that God approved that marriage. Because many marriage that is in the world right now, many of them are not approved at all. Let me say over 85% of marriage are not approved by God. Meanwhile, the husband and the wife are still calling themselves husband and wife. The husband have paid the dowry and they have been living together. Meanwhile, God did not approve it. There are some marriage, I'm going to explain to you by God's grace, maybe tomorrow, we are going to talk about what are the three things that is going to make your marriage legalistic, and what are the things that if you have it, the marriage will never be approved. Will never be approved. What are the things you can do that can make your marriage not to be approved? And what are the things that you can do that can make your wife be approved? What are the things that have to be in alliance before a marriage can be approved? Tomorrow I'm going to explain it. Many people are into wrong marriage. And let me tell you something. When you miss it in marriage, you have missed heaven. Because marriage is part of an arrangement for people. It's either you are not married at all or you are married. So if you are married, you have to make sure you marry right. And you marry without an error. I'm also going to talk about some couples who have intercourse before marriage. Maybe during their fiance life, when they are still courting themselves, they have intercourse. Re-intercourse. Or the man broke the virginity if the woman is a virgin. During the time they are still courting. What are the things that can cause it? I'm going to explain to you by the grace of God. But everything is going to be in the gradual process. We are still in a realm of error in the church, and we have dealing with the pastor that is joining a pregnant woman together. So may the Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Share this to everyone and let them know that it's an error to have a marriage in the house of God when you are pregnant. God bless you. God be with you. Shalom.